Let's talk about social media preview images. I encourage you to build your brand by sharing events or blog posts or information from your website to your different social media accounts. This will help bring people back to your website and encourage some brand loyalty to you and not necessarily the different social media accounts. What happens sometimes though is people will share a page, or maybe you even have a little share button on different parts of your site, and visitors will share your page. In fact, that's probably to be encouraged. But the display just doesn't show what you want, and it's very frustrating. So let's do a little demo here on how that happens. What social media does is it will look for what's called open graph tags in the code. And I'll go ahead and show you an image of that right here of what that looks like. You'll be able to look at the code of the page that you're visiting and see it's lying there underneath. And so social media will look for that first. And if it doesn't see anything specific, it will generally choose the image that's the first one on the page. Here I'm logged in as a user to this testing site, and I have the new Joomla extension for SEO installed. And you'll see that when I click on here, it opens up some information and it shares with me the search engine preview on mobile or desktop for this particular page, so that when someone searches on a search engine, this is what they will most likely see. Also gives you the opportunity to change that if you'd like. Here on tab number two, it shows me social networks. So what I see here is that right now it has this, as I said, that first image on the page itself, not the template, but the page. And that's not a bad image, but I have prepared an image that I'd like to have in its place. Now I've prepared the image at a specific size, which is, well, I have it here somewhere. Where is it? Oh, 1200 by 630 pixels, and I've had really good results with that image. Now you'll want to take into account that there will be some cropping depending on the social media account. So go ahead and give it a little wiggle room here. I have already uploaded an image to the server, so let me go ahead and add it. To add it, and there it is. I've got that same image actually, but with a couple other things put in there and some text information, so that when I share this page about the party, it'll give something enticing for people to click on. So let's go ahead and save that. And there's also a built-in way to check at the Facebook debugger, so let's take a look at it. And it does have a warning here, so I'll go ahead and look up what that is. But I want you to see that it does show you a preview of what it will look like, and that's before you've actually shared it. So you don't have to share it, say, oops, I made a mistake, and then go ahead and choose another image and make your corrections. So this debugger is very nice. There's also a built-in debugger for Twitter. Other considerations, of course, are, Instagram, LinkedIn, any social media account, and there's so many now, actually. But I have found that the consistent image size of 1200 by 630 works pretty well across almost all the platforms. I do want to mention, too, that you are also able to, with this for SEO extension, have a consistent image through the entire site. So let's say you have a site and you really don't want to have a different image for every page, and it's just a little bit, some of the images are bad. You can go ahead, and here's a site I just recently completed, and I have it set up so that every page on the site has this little card that gives the direct message that we would like the user to see whenever a page from this site is shared.